So the subclavius in the bovine is going to attach down on the cartilage of the first rib and come up and attach to the medial surface of our brachiocephalic muscle. So that's the subclavius muscle right there in the bovine. Okay, so some of the differences in the bovine, starting here on the lateral side, we have here the deltoideus, and you can't see real well in this specimen, but there is actually an acromial head to the deltoideus because there is an acromium in the bovine. And so there are some other specimens that show that better. And coming on down here is our extensor carpi radialis. Now, we have a medial digital extensor that we don't in the horse. And you can see here its tendon is going to come down and just go to the medial digit. And then this next one is going to be the common digital extensor. Its tendon is the middle one here. And you can't see it there, but you can see it more down here. It's going to split so it goes to both digits. Okay. And then here is our lateral digital extensor, followed on down, so and it just goes to the lateral digit. Okay, so most of the rest of the muscles are pretty much the same. We may see, I think it's right here, a very small pronator teres. It doesn't have any pronation action, it's more just a flexor of the elbow. Obviously not a primary flexor. Just like in the horse, the flexor carpi ulnaris overlies the superficial digital flexor. And the superficial digital flexor in the bovine actually has two heads, which isn't dissected out real well here, but you'll see that both tendons are going to come together down in here. So you'll be able to trace out those tendons of the superficial coming together more distally here. So we've got two heads, the rest of these heads down in here being the deep digital flexor, and of course this being the flexor carpi radialis muscle. The nerves are pretty much the same, they course pretty much the same. We have axillary and radial. Our suprascapular is up here, median and ulnar running together, median and musculocutaneous running together, with our musculocutaneous leaving here, median coming on down. Now, distally, we're not going to worry so much about the innervation because in the bovine, generally, what we're going to do is we're going to either inject into the most abaxial veins, which would be the palmar common digital 2 and 4, or we would go to the dorsal surface and get the palmar common, the dorsal common digital 3, and we would put a tourniquet on and inject into any one of those to anesthetize. So we don't do nerve blocks like we do in a horse. So we're not going to worry so much about the branches, just kind of FYI. The more dorsal surface here is going to be innervated by the superficial radial. Remember, in the horse, the radial nerve has no innervation distal to the carpus. Okay, the abaxial, both dorsal and palmarly, on the fourth is going to be innervated by the ulnar. And then the more palmar of the rest of the digits is going to be by the median. That's just more FYI. The vasculature is going to be pretty much the same, except that the median is going to course down much more further. We'll come down here and we'll have a branch coming into the median, which is going to be the communicating branch that passes through the metatarsal distally, so it's the distal perforating metatarsal. At that point it becomes the palmar common digital 3 artery, and what's important for us is that we're going to have a dorsal one too. That's going to, they're going to join in the, as an interdigital artery. But what's more important, as I was saying, is that they're going to then give off an artery that will branch and give rise to our palmar axial digital arteries 3 and 4, which are the primary supply to the digit. And one of the things you want to consider when you're doing a digital amputation is that we want to maintain the blood supply to that bone that we're cutting, which is generally going to be the first phalanx. And so we cut that at an angle like so, so that that blood supply is still entering that bone. But also cutting it at an angle is good, because then you don't have a stub out here that's going to get hung up on stuff.